and skate harder to the bench, fellas.
Get to know Gulls head coach Kevin Dineen.
I was around so many incredible players.
What it's like to get your own bobblehead, a unique one at that.
Wow.
And the Gulls show their dedication to the local youth at a number of appearances.
They get a gift card and we get to help them pick out some gifts for their family.
That and plenty more on this edition of Gulls All Access.
For Carrick, wrap around. Score!
Overtime in hockey, when every shot could be the game winner, is incredibly exciting.
Larson, he's got a step on the defense. Larson in, scores! Game over!
And it's even better when the Gulls win.
4-3, San Diego.
Hello everyone, I'm Andy Zilch with Emily Harlan. And on this week's edition of Gulls All Access, we're coming to you from Balboa Park.
We begin with a man who has played in the National Hockey League, was part of a Stanley Cup winner, and has been a head coach in the NHL.
And that's Gulls' first-year head coach, Kevin Dineen. I was able to sit down and talk with him to get a feel for the team and learn his story.
Go, go. I want 2D! 2D!
A few months into your role as the coach of the Gulls, what's been the most pleasant surprise for you upon coming here?
Well, I don't know if it's a surprise, but I heard the stories, but the enthusiasm and just the passion of our fan base has just been fabulous.
Okay, so what's been the biggest challenge for you so far here?
Well, we were in Anaheim for a really long stretch and we came back. I think we had two days before our first game, our first road trip, and presented some challenges. I think I took too long to put people in roles that would lead to team success. So, you're always reflecting and trying to decide how you do things better.
That's it, right through them. Just kill it in there, Seals. Kill it, okay. We settled that down, better.
Things have started to turn the right direction here as we approach Christmas, but a lot of work to be done, but we're excited. We got great character players in the locker room. And a lot of positives to build on in our most recent past.
So we're going to go back to your youth, born in Quebec. Your father played in the U.S., though professionally at the time. Where did you spend much of your youth, and what was it like?
I was born in Quebec City. My dad was playing there before we moved to Seattle. And I was there till basically kindergarten or first grade. And then we went from Seattle to Denver, Colorado. I was in Denver grade 3 and 4. I was in Houston, Texas, grade 5 through grade 9, Connecticut, grade 10, 11 and 12, we were in Toronto, went off to college a couple years at Denver, and then played on the Canadian Olympic team, so was based out of Calgary, and in saying that, what a great life, and always being exposed to a sport that's been so good to me and my family.
Who's your favorite player as a kid?
Oh boy, that's a tough one. I was around so many incredible players. My dad being a player growing up and then being on the coaching side of it, I was just exposed to some incredible people. When he coached his teams in Houston, Texas in the WHA, I was probably at that really influential age and would go down, we'd spend all day at the rink and we'd skate with the guys before and after practice and you're around the locker room. Obviously the Howe family was a huge impact on us, but we also grew up mostly in the States. And there's a man named Larry Lund who ran a hockey school in British Columbia that we used to go to every summer. I think it was a great way to grow up.
Where's his options? There you go, indirect.
When did you realize, all right, hockey's going to be my profession, I can take this and be a pro and make some money while doing it?
Well, I probably didn't think about that until I was drafted. I mean, my dad was in a scouting position at that time, and you know what, for me, my main goal was a chance to be able to play hockey at the college level, and I was fortunate enough to do that at the University of Denver. As a young kid, when I went to school, I was only 17, so I got drafted after my freshman year in the third round by Hartford. It was kind of like, oh, you know what, maybe you do have a chance of being a pro player. And I had played defense my whole life, basically, until my first pro training camp. And I went to my first pro camp. It was a kind of decision time. I was offered a contract, and that's probably when the reality that, you know what, you can do this for a living set in. So tough decision, but left after my, well, it was my third year, including the Olympic year, and turned pro at that time.
Thanks, Andy. There's another champion on the Gulls. Andrew Podorowski was with the Charlotte Checkers last season when they won the Calder Cup. So he earned a championship ring, but he didn't receive that ring until recently when the Gulls surprised him with it at a team dinner.
It is my pleasure. The league has asked me on behalf of the league and behalf of the Charlotte Checkers organization to present Andrew with his Calder Cup championship ring. Andrew, well deserved. So now you're going to get another one this year, you realize that?
Oh, yeah.
All right. So.
Yeah, it was awesome to be presented like that in front of all the guys here. It's definitely a special special thing to do and special thing to always remember. And to be a part of that Charlotte team, it'll stick with me for the rest of my life. So to have a piece of hardware is definitely pretty cool. All the relationships I built in Charlotte and the 3.5 years I spent there were unforgettable, and I always cherish everything. And we were so close in that locker room, every one of us. And we're kind of brothers there, and it's something I'll cherish for the rest of my life and I'll always remember. And I just want to say a big thank you to everybody in that organization, from Michael Kahn down. And what they did for us was unbelievable, and they're a huge part of our success. So thank you to them and everyone in the Checkers organization.
Thanks, Andy. Coming up, we'll show you some of the fun from Lucha Libre Night at the arena.
In part two of Chase DeLeo Zookeeper, we'll show you how Chase earned the applause of a gorilla.
And later, the Gulls are skating and shopping to help local kids.
That and more on the way as Gulls All Access continues. Gulls fans, if you can't make it out to the Pechanga Arena San Diego on December 21st, you can catch the game right here on Fox 5. I'll be joined by former Gull B.J. McPherson to bring you the action as the Gulls take on the Stockton Heat at 7 o'clock.
The Gulls supported this year's 26th annual Shop with a Cop, hosted by SDSU and UCSD police departments. The purpose was to provide children with a happier holiday season and to encourage positive interaction with law enforcement. 330 third grade students from 50 different schools across San Diego County were chosen to shop at Target in the Midway District for holiday gifts.
Hi. I'll follow you wherever you go. Let's go.
Yay! Yay! Come on, everybody get playing warmer.
Charity for Children was again the focus when the Gulls front office visited the Jacobs and Cushman Food Bank. There they assisted with the Food for Kids Backpack Program. It provides weekend food packages to chronically hungry elementary school students who may go without eating on weekends when there aren't any school lunches.
We have a trained nutritionist on staff. We have 4 different menus. We want healthy kids who can be healthy students, who can get a good education, grow up, get a good job, and not be dependent on the food bank. So it's all about ending the cycle of poverty.
Well, recently the Gulls celebrated Mexico's passion for professional wrestling on Lucha Libre Night.
That phrase means freestyle wrestling, and some of the wrestlers known as luchadores wear masks.
The Gulls celebrated with a special pregame tailgate party and even gave fans a masked Sam Carrick bobblehead. The night kicked off with live wrestling matches at the Gulls tailgate.
We're here to challenge Judiz for the SoCal Pro Heavyweight Championship of the World.
Then game, fans made their way to the entrances where they were treated to a unique Sam Carrick Lucha Libre bobblehead giveaway.
Some of the Gulls were given a sneak peek at the bobblehead.
Wow. That is so cool. The detail in it is just unbelievable. It looks like it's been hand painted by an artist. It's pretty spot on with my facial hair, a little bit of chin, a little bit of a mustache. The one thing is the head might be a little bigger than what I have, but that's that's pretty good.
Oh, that's really good actually. I was completely not expecting them to have a cape and mask on.
Looks like a superhero.
Kind of look like Sammy. Sammy's a big head too, so.
I'd say the size of the head and the height of the bobblehead is A+.
Some good lips, look plump. Got the duck face going a little bit.
I mean, it's probably better there's a mask on.
What I see is the flames is a pretty cool touch on the back.
A little jealous, to be honest. I wish I had one of these for myself with a wrestling costume on.
Probably just gonna let my dog chew on it.
This is exactly how I'd look if that was my second job, is doing a little wrestling on the side. This would definitely be my number one look that I'd go for.
And it goes in!
In the main event, the Gulls and Colorado battled to a 3-3 tie.
Sidorov in front, few jams, scores! As Seeloff shoots and scores!
Jacob Larson's game-winning overtime goal provided the final knockout.
Step on the defense, Larson in, scores! Game over! Jacob Larson wins it in extra time, 4-3 San Diego.
Lucha Libre night was a great night with a perfect finish. The San Diego Gulls will have many more good promotions coming your way, so you can check it out on the website. Go to sandiegogulls.com.
And now we go back to the zoo. Last show, Chase DeLeo fed giraffes and learned his way around a koala cage. This time, he earns the applause of a happy gorilla.
Ready to check out some gorillas today?
Yes, let's do it.
All right, cool. Let's head on in. So we have a total of 6 gorillas, 2 different groups. So we have a family group, and then we have a group of bachelors that are inside right now.
Awesome.
So you're going to get to meet our family group today.
Perfect.
They're out on exhibit, so I thought we'd prep some enrichment, cut up some fresh veggies and stuff for them.
Perfect.
She's ready. She gets very impatient. She says, excuse me, right
no
here.
No way is she clapping.
Yeah. They're a lot of fun to work with, just like the elephants. They're super, super intelligent.
Yeah.
So with our males especially, we've been doing training with blood pressure cuffs. Because unfortunately one of the leading causes of death for male gorillas is cardiac disease.
Thank you very much for showing me.
I'm glad you could come out and check these guys out today.
Yeah,
I mean,
awesome.
Just creating awareness about, you know, the apes and all the endangered species that we have here. But I mean, really people coming to visit is what really helps to conserve these animals for future generations. So.
Absolutely.
Because these guys are such a joy and we love sharing them with everybody.
Yeah, so. I appreciate it. Thank you very much again. So much work that goes on behind the scenes here, and just in the little bit that I have seen so far, it's incredible. It's so clean, everything, and obviously all the zookeepers love their job.
Yeah, well, I'm glad you noticed that. I mean, it is, you know, working with animals, being an animal care specialist, a keeper, working with endangered species, it is a work of passion.
Yeah.
You know, we are all emotionally tethered into each individual animal we care for, but we also see the bigger picture too, then, as far as how we're helping the species and how we can get our guests involved in helping the species as well. So I'm glad you had a chance to see that and kind of witness that yourself.
Yeah,
but yeah, we definitely love what we do, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Coming up, the Gulls Winter Wonderland returns. We'll let you know when and where.
And we'll show you how the Gulls are doing their part to improve the lives of local children.
If you're still in the market for the perfect gift for your favorite Gulls fan, here's a deal he or she will like. The Gulls Holiday Pack includes two tickets to three games, a Gulls stocking, and a holiday card set. Go to sandiegogulls.com/holidaypack for details and to order.
Gulls fans can also have a blast at Winter Wonderland at the arena on December 21st before the Gulls host Stockton. Fans will also receive a snow globe for attending the game that night. Here's a look at last year's Winter Wonderland.
The Gulls continued their outreach to the community with two recent events that benefited children.
The team skated, signed autographs, and shopped for San Diego's youth.
The Gulls joined other professional, collegiate, and Olympic athletes for the annual Shop with a Jock event.
Tonight we're doing Shop with a Jock here at Target. We get to hang out with a little kid tonight and kind of walk them through Target. They get a gift card and we get to help them pick out some gifts for their family. So I'm looking forward to it, and we're gonna have a good time. I'm excited to see the look on the kids' face, and it's a great holiday for giving back, and it'll be fun to see the kids do that. It's really important to our team and our organization to give back to the community, and we do that really well as a team here in San Diego, and we enjoy doing it.
You sure, this way?
Yeah. Oh, well,
to see all the kids' faces, to help them, it's a great feeling for us, and see how happy they are. And it's the holiday season, so it's nice to give back to them and so they can shop for their families and friends. So we're really happy to be here, and it's fun to do this too. So
I'm going over 100 for sure.
Awesome event. I was paired up with Elias, and he kind of walked me through the whole story. He had a laundry list of stuff he kind of wanted, and everything seemed to be for everyone but himself. It was really cool, pretty humbling. He got his dad something, his mom something, his niece, his sister, all something, and he walked out of the building with just a lunchbox. So it was pretty cool to see him thinking pretty selflessly in a situation like this. You could tell the guys enjoyed it. Everyone had a smile on. I think we're all fortunate to have really good kids too, which made it a lot easier. So awesome event, and I think all of the players are just really happy that events like this are put on and organized, and you know, we just have to show up and, you know, try to give a little bit of help. You know, you don't know some of the situations that kids are coming from, their backgrounds, and you know, being able to take them out and, you know, walk around the store and have them just be able to pick out some stuff and see their face light up when they find something they actually like or want, definitely is something that I cherish, and I think most of the guys do.
Recently, the entire Gulls team went to Liberty Station to skate with some very important patients from Rady Children's Hospital.
So tonight, we've got the Gulls here from 5 to 7, and they're skating with kids, helping bring awareness to the Rady Children's Ice Rink, which benefits the Thriving After Cancer program at Rady Children's Hospital.
Yeah, I think it's great to be a part of an organization that gives back to the community. I think as players, it's always fun to come out and spend time with the community and give back. And do as much as we can help raise awareness of certain foundations or causes. So this is an event that guys always get up for and are excited to come out for.
It's really nice to be in this city, first of all, and to be here at Rady's Ice Rink with all these fans and all these people. It's nice. I mean, it means a lot, obviously. Like I said, not everyone's fortunate enough. You know, we do this for a living, so it's nice to get out here and share a good time with them.
You see some of the young kids out here that can skate super well. I think just the team being in San Diego is helping grow in the sport around the city, and for us to be out here and spending time in the community, it's great to grow the game and to show support for our fans, for all they do for us.
I mean, when you are a child at a hospital, day in, day out for treatments, to be able to come and do something that's really normal, like ice skating, it just means everything. Creating memories with their family makes them feel happy and sort of re-energizes and recharges them to go back to the hospital for other treatments. Where else can you skate outside under palm trees and the lights? It's perfect.
The ice is pretty good out here. I was surprised. You know, it's nice. It's not super cold. And I think everyone's having a good time.
Being able to partner with the Gulls means everything to Rady Children's Hospital Auxiliary. We couldn't be ambassadors for the hospital and fundraise like we do without community partners. And the Gulls are so important to us. We just can't thank them enough for everything that they do for us, for the ice rink, and for the kids at the hospital.
Go Gulls!
The Gulls will also be gathering toys for the patients at Rady Children's Hospital and its neighbor, the Ronald McDonald House. If you'd like to help, please bring a new unwrapped toy to the Gulls game on December 21st.
They will be collected at the arena entrances. The Gulls Toy Drive is brought to you by San Diego Honda Dealers.
Well, that's a wrap from here in beautiful Balboa Park.
For Emily Harlan, I'm Andy Zilch. Thanks for watching Gulls All Access, and have a fun and safe holiday season.